everybody. I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to my craft room. So happy to have you here. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make these viral candy cane designs. You guys begged for a full tutorial, so I'm going to slide one in here so that you guys can learn how to make these. I made a couple different names just so you could see some of the examples of what they're going to look like, but I'm going to show you how to make this one. And once you know how to make one, you know how to make all of them. This is a lot easier than it looks. I promise you'll be able to follow along. If you run into any trouble, be sure to leave your questions down below in the comments. I'm always happy to help you guys create fun things with your Cricut. So without further ado, let's get started. But be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. The first thing that you're going to need in order to make the candy cane design is, of course, a candy cane. Now I'm going to show you two ways that you can do this, because if you don't have Design Space access, you'll need to get the SVG, and I'll link the one down below. But if you're going to use an SVG from outside of Design Space, you'll need to use the upload option, which is on the left hand side of your screen. Then you're going to click upload image and you can browse for it or drag and drop your file. Now you're going to want to make sure that you're using the SVG version of this, because we do need to have layers. Now I want to point out that my candy cane has three colors. It has black, red, and white, which is exactly what I want it to have, because I need to have a couple of layers of this for it to work. So I'm going to click continue. I'm going to go ahead and all I have to do here is click upload. It's going to put this directly into my Cricut Design Space. Now, if you're using Design Space Access in your images, they have a bunch of different candy canes that you can choose from. And you can see they're all very similar. I mean, candy canes are all going to be pretty darn similar. So you can find one that looks just like the one that I have or similar enough. I don't know if I love the style of that one, so I can go through and find maybe one that I like a little bit better. This one's a little more like what I'm thinking, so I'm going to get rid of this one. But again, you'll notice that we've got the three layers. We want to have those three colors. Now, again, this is not exactly what I want, but it's fine to show you how to do this. Now, I want to pull the one from Design Space apart just so you can see there are three layers to this, and I'm going to ungroup this. These steps are going to be exactly the same regardless of which candy cane you use. I'm going to use this one because I like the style of it better, but you use whatever candy cane you like. Just be sure that you have some layers to this. So I'm going to delete this one from Design Space because I don't want to use that one, but all the directions will be the same regardless of where your candy cane came from. Now you'll notice that mine is grouped. So the first thing that I want to do is I need to ungroup this, but we have multiple groups the way that this was designed, and that's okay. First, I'm going to click ungroup to ungroup this major group, and then you've got a smaller group here filled with more groups, because what this person did when they designed this is all the red pieces are a group and all the white pieces are a group. Now, for this, we just need to make sure that everything is completely ungrouped. So everywhere you see the word group, I want you to click on it, and then you're going to click this button right here, which is your ungroup. And you'll see here, this is a group, so we're going to ungroup it. You're going to do the same thing for your white. So you're going to click that and you're going to ungroup. Now, because we have all these different layers, what we want to do is we want to attach like colors. So I want to make sure all that these white pieces are attached. So I'm going to click attach. Now, the red pieces are not technically going to matter, but just for this tutorial, I'm just going to show you that I select all my red and I attach, and you'll understand why that red doesn't fully matter here in just 1 second. So what I want to do now is create the layers that I need for my candy cane. Now I technically only need two layers for this design. I need a red layer and I need a white layer. So in order to make these two layers that are going to be a little bit easier to place together, I'm going to take this candy cane here, the black one, and I'm going to duplicate it because this is going to become our back red layer. Go ahead and change the color of that to red. Now I know that this gets a little bit confusing, but this is definitely a more advanced designing technique and a more advanced design like situation. So that's why it can be just a little bit confusing. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to slice out the red section from the black. And the reason that I'm doing that is because I want to be able to see the red through the main background. So I'm going to take and I'm going to grab my red section, which is this. Now, if I grab my black, you'll notice that I can't slice. But what I can do is I can come down to combine and I can use the exclude option. And now you'll notice that it gives me just this layer of black.
Now, if you want to slice it, let me go ahead and undo this. If you really do want to slice this, what you'll need to do is select your attach option, go down and combine, and use the weld option, because that's going to make it all one single layer. Then you can use the slice with your black layer. So if you select your welded result and your black, now you can use slice, and you'll see that you get the exact same results. You just did it in a different way. Now, we don't need any more of these. We don't need the little slices here, these little candy cane pieces. So you can just go ahead and delete those. Now, you'll see here that our black layer is black, obviously. I'm going to change it to white to help us with visualization. And then I'm also going to change our background color on Design Space so that you can really see that white a little bit better. Now, I'm going to pull these over here and I'm going to pull them apart because I want to show you something. You want both of these layers to be the exact same size, which they should be, but I always want to double check. So this is 2.54 by 5.42. So if I check this, it's the same size, and you can see that right up here at the top. Now that I've got them both the same size, I'm going to go ahead, select both items, and I'm going to align them and center them. And I'll make this bigger so that you guys can see quite a bit easier what I'm doing. So now what we're going to do is add our name, and I'll just use my name, but you can use any name that you want. You could even use words. You could put like Christmassy words. You could put encouragement, whatever you want to put on it, you can do, but I'm just going to use my name. So I'm going to open up my text box and of course just type in my name. Now what's really great about this is you can use any font that you want to, script fonts, fun fonts, whatever it may be, you can use those. So I'm going to go into my system fonts and you see I've got things like this one that's really cute. Awesome Everyday Caps is cute. Just find something that you like and go with it. You can even do something that's a little bit thinner if you want to. It's really, truly up to you what you want to do with this and the way you want it to look. Enjoy Summer is a really cute one that I like, and I'll link a couple of my font favorites down below for you. But let me find a fun font that we can do with this. Let's do this, Groovy Xmas. I just got this font and I think it's so darling, and I'll link it down below if you want to use it. So what I'm going to do here with this font is the first thing, and this is for visual sake, I'm going to turn this so that it is kind of at that same angle as my candy cane. And then I'm going to stretch this out so that it fits on my candy cane. Now you can make this really as big or as small as you want. I want it a little bit smaller, but I also think I want to stretch the letters out a little bit. So what I want to do is I'm going to go up here to the top where the size button is, and I'm going to get this lock, and I'm just going to click on it because now I can stretch my name out a little bit, and you'll notice that it doesn't stretch here. But what you do is if you grab this corner, you'll see here now I can stretch this and change its scale to however I want it to look. So I want it to be a little taller. I don't want it super wide because I do still want it to fit on the candy cane and not take up the entire candy cane. Now what I'm going to do here is just visualize, because this isn't going to be exactly where it ends up sitting, but this is going to give us kind of that look and idea of what we want it to look like. Now I need to add an offset to my letters, because that offset is going to become the back part of your design, and it's going to allow your name to show up on your candy cane. So what we'll do here is we are going to create the offset by just using this offset button. Now I don't care what size offset you make. You make it whatever size you want it to be. You are really the person who decides this. I'm not telling you what size you need to be because it's all up to you. It does not matter what size your offset is. You can make it super big and blobby if you want. You can make it smaller and a little more demure if you want. You do whatever design you like. There's no right or wrong way. Now, I do prefer a little bit thicker on these just so that it's going to stand out a little bit more. So I've got it at like 0.23, but you do whatever works best for you. Then I'm going to click apply. Now, what I need is to have two of the offsets so that I can weld them to the two layers of the candy cane, because you need to have something to layer on top of. So both of the candy canes need to be the exact same shape. So what you're going to do is you're going to duplicate this offset. You don't need to duplicate the letters. You can if it's easier for you, but you don't need to. Then I'm going to grab the letters, which is my text of Corinne, both offsets, and I'm going to go to align and I'm going to center them. Now, remember, I said that wasn't right where it was going to sit because every time you center with the offset, it moves it a little. So from here is where you're going to figure out where you want your offset and your name to sit. Again, you can really do this however you want. If you want it like this, if you want it up here, wherever you want it. I prefer it on the like stick of the candy cane. And I think maybe a little more this way. Now, once I have that sitting where I want it, and again, sit it where you want it. It's up to you. Once I'm happy with that, I want to take one of my offsets and I'm going to weld it to the white. So I have the offset and the white selected, and I'm going to go ahead, go down to combine, and I want to weld them. Now you're going to sort of start to see that visual of what your design is going to look like, but we need to take the second offset and we also need to weld that to the red. So again, that they're the same shape. Now, if I hide the text and I like kind of open and hide that, see how the red and the white are the same shape. You have the bumps from the letters on both shapes. That's absolutely what you want. Now your final step is to take the word, whatever it may be, and you want to slice it out of your white because that's going to allow the red to show through. So I want to select my text and select the white weld result, and I'm going to go down to slice. Now, again, you can use exclude too, whichever works best for you, but you want to delete both of the slice results that are the letters. And now, do you see what your candy cane is going to look like? Does that give you a better visual? This is exactly what your candy cane will be. So you're going to have one layer that is white and one layer that is the solid color. Now, let me just say this. I don't recommend doing the white layer in cardstock, especially if you have a lot of little letter centers. You can absolutely do it, but you'd have to glue those on. I personally like to use vinyl because I just do find that to be a little bit easier. Now let's say, okay, cool, great, but I want to hang this or I want to use this as a gift tag. This part is so simple. All you're going to do is grab a shape and you're going to use a circle. You can really use kind of any shape, but the circle is going to really look best. I'm going to change the color of this circle to red and I'm going to duplicate it and I'm going to make this circle any other color. It does not matter. I want to take this red circle and I'm going to size it down a little bit just so it's not so big, because this is where you're going to hang your ribbon or whatever you're going to hang this with. Then I'm going to take the green circle and I'm going to go ahead and size this down a bit so that it leaves me with some edge to this circle that's here. Now I'm going to take both of my circles, so the red and the green circle. You're going to align them and center them just so you can make sure that everything is nice and centered. And then you're going to use the slice option. You're going to delete both of the full circles, leaving you with your outline circle. Now it does not matter that it kind of overlaps into your red and you're going to have kind of like a semicircle for your string to go through. That doesn't matter. If you don't want it to do that, you can move your circle, but I don't really care. Kind of prefer it with the semicircle. I think it gives it a little more strength. So I'm going to go ahead and select the circle outline and the red candy cane. I'm going to go to combine and I'm going to weld them. Now, when I take and I put my white, which is under it, I'm going to right click on this and I'm just going to bring that to the front. Now, when I put the white over it, you'll see how nice and neat this looks. Now, I can't always get it perfectly lined up when I'm on my screen, but this is where you're going to hang it from, right up here. And then you're going to have your name and everything right there. Now, obviously, this is huge right now. It's a little bit bigger than I would probably make this. Usually for like if you want to use it for an ornament or like a name tag for a gift, which would be so stinking cute. I don't tend to go more than like 5 inches tall, but you do you and figure out like how big you want to make yours. Now I am going to make this bigger since we're doing this on screen and I want you guys to be able to see this really well, especially when I put it together. So I'm going to make mine pretty large because I am going to show you guys how to assemble this. It is so easy and so simple. Now I have made other ones and let me show you those really quick just so you can kind of see the difference. Now these are three others that I made and you can see that I used some different types of text for all of them. They're lined up a little bit differently. So you can see there are lots of ways to do this. Now I also made this one really fun one down here, which is so stinking cute. Let me scroll down. So you can see you can take that knowledge that you've learned and use it to create other designs. You'll see here that this is again two layers. So it's the white layer and the red layer and you'll see that they're the same shape. Just one has some designs cut out of it. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the big Corinne one for you so that you guys can see that. Now again, play with this, have fun with it, do whatever you want, make them as fancy, like with this one with Shelly on it, got lots of fun script fonts. You can do something a little more plain like I have here on Nick, and you can make these any colors that you want to, holographic paper, plain cardstock, all sorts of things. I'm going to use some metallic cardstock and some StarCraft HD white vinyl. So let's head over to the Cricut machine. We'll get these all cut out. I'm going to show you how easy it is to assemble them. And now you're going to know exactly how to make your own fun name candy cane. We're ready to cut here on the machine, so I'm just going to load my vinyl onto my standard grip mat. Now this one is not super sticky, so I'm also going to use it for the cardstock. I'm cutting my StarCraft HD permanent vinyl on the regular vinyl setting, and then when I load the metallic cardstock, I cut that on the medium cardstock setting, and that seems to work best.
Now that you have weeded out your vinyl, mine's a little curly because it's been on a roll for a while, but you'll have your cardstock piece, because remember, this is your back piece, is your cardstock piece, and then the front piece is going to be your vinyl. Now yours will be smaller than this, unless you want to make a big one, which you could. I'm going to go ahead and grab some transfer tape. Now it's important to use like a decent transfer tape that's going to work with cardstock. This is the Style Tech transfer tape. I have a whole video where I compare transfer tapes, and I think if you haven't seen it, you'll want to see it because it is super helpful picking the right transfer tape for your project. So I'm going to lay mine down, face down on to the tape, and then I'm just going to trim this out and give this a little quick zhuzh with a squeegee, especially since you can see like it's curling off up a bunch. I don't want it to do that, so we're going to go ahead and grab a squeegee. Now you want to burnish, and I always recommend just burnishing from the back. It just works so well, and I'm just going to burnish this. Now we do have a chunk that doesn't have any vinyl there, so I'm going to trim that off just now, just so it's out of my way, because I don't need it. Then I'm going to flip this over, and I'm going to remove the backing from my design here, and you'll see how well that sticks, but you'll also see how well it comes off. Now, when I line this up, I like to use the parchment paper hack. This works anytime you're laying vinyl down on to anything. It's so helpful. I'm going to grab a piece of parchment paper here with my little candy cane. Now, I'm going to leave just a smidge of my candy cane hanging out. I just want that little edge. You can see there's just a tiny piece over here hanging out. I'm going to start down here at the bottom of my candy cane, and I want to get it lined up completely so that my bottom is even and my arch up here is even, as well as this right here. Down here on this arch is where I've been messing them up a couple times. Now, listen, is it perfect every single time? Sure it is not. But this one looks pretty good, so I pressed down right where that just tiny, tiny little piece is holding this down, and then I'm going to wiggle this out. Now, when I do that, I need to be really, really careful not to move anything, and I'm just going to very gently lay my design down, and it got a little off-center. That can happen. Just take your time. It's okay if it's a little off. Mine got just a smidge off. Nobody will notice it. And honestly, it's harder to do this when I do them this big. It's much easier when they're smaller. There's way less surface area to mess up, but that's okay. This still came out pretty good. So now what you're going to have is both pieces stuck to your transfer tape. That's okay. You're going to very gently roll your transfer tape off. Now, I will say that I do recommend using a lighter tack transfer tape like the Style Tech for this. But if your transfer tape's a little extra tacky, stick it to your table, stick it to your pants, stick it to your shirt, and it'll take some of the tack off, and that'll help it not stick to your paper as much. Now, is it 100% perfect? No, it wiggled a little bit on the bottom, but it did come out really, really cute. And like I said, I can add a little like paper or a little ribbon to this. I can hang this. I can use this as a gift tag. You could add words to this and make them ornaments. Whatever you want to do, you can also add extra layers of paper if you want to maybe make it a little stiffer. You can use a stiffer paper. Whatever you want to do with these. Use whatever colors you want, patterns, designs. This would be really pretty with a patterned vinyl behind it because this offset will make your name stand out really well. But this is a really fun thing to do, but give yourself some grace. You may mess it up, but what is great is you can always just hit the undo button in Design Space. Now, if you have any questions, please let me know in those comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.